And welcome back, our dear viewers. As we promised at the beginning of the show, we are going to talk today about the visit by French President François Hollande to Egypt, which was wrapped up today after a three-day visit, during which he had many activities. He met with President Abdel Fattah el-Sisi. He went to the House of Representatives, the first French president to be there. And he met with the House Speaker, Ali Abdel Aal. And also he met with Prime Minister Sharif Ismail. There was yesterday the Egyptian-French Economic Forum. Many agreements and memorandum of understandings were signed. Many issues of mutual concern were tackled during this very important visit by the French president to Egypt. To shed more light on that very important visit, we are very much delighted to have our dear guest in the studio, Ambassador Ali Hefni, former assistant to the foreign minister. Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning, Mr. Ambassador. As Bahisi just said, that President Hollande has wrapped up his visit to Egypt. So let's focus on the outcomes of this visit.
Well, once again, it's a very important visit. Egypt is tackling such visits differently than we used to do in the past.
Yes.
And especially at the level of the head of state. It's a follow-up visit. We do recall that President Fattah el-Sisi has paid an official visit to France and has started to tackle many aspects of our relations, discussing about many new deals with France that has opened the door for further cooperation. And for us, for the two countries and the two people, to witness a really new momentum in the relations between Egypt and France. He's accompanied by an important delegation of entrepreneurs. And the visit has dealt, or the two leaders, they have well prepared the ground for this visit, and this is how we see that it covers many fields of cooperation, and we have signed many
agreements
memos, and it makes you feel optimistic about the future relationship between the two countries. On condition that we ensure a good follow-up of all the files that have been under discussion during the visits, or during the whole phase of preparation for the visit. It's an official visit, and this is why President Hollande is spending more time. It's not a working visit. And he has been received, or he has met with the Prime Minister, was received at the deputies or the House of Deputies. He had the opportunity during the visit to meet with President Sisi more than one time.
Indeed.
So they had the opportunity to interact, to talk, to exchange views. Of course, President Hollande and his delegation should have felt that they are dealing with a new Egypt. It's not the same Egypt as before. It's a different Egypt after June 30, 2013. And especially in our approach dealing with the visit, or dealing with our relations with France. Egypt's importance has increased lately. We are dealing with a very ambitious economic and social plan. We are preparing our files much better than we used to do before. We have gone into and deeply so many details having to do with different aspects of our cooperation and our relationship. Egypt has become a member of the Security Council, a member of the African Union Council for Peace and Security. Egypt has been very active as far as its relationship with Africa. And of course, Africa is important for France as, well. As it is mm-hmm. For Egypt. France has forces in Mali, in the Central African Republic. Again, we raise the issue of the trilateral cooperation in Africa for the sake of the African countries, sake of development in Africa. We have what to offer to Africa and, of course, the French as well. So from many angles, the visit has been different this time and has been important for the two countries. Now, there is another issue that is at the focus of the attention of the two countries, which is the counter-terrorism. We have had our share. We are one of the main countries that has suffered a lot out of terrorist acts and the activities of the violence caused by the terrorist organizations, and France as well, and Europe. We have seen it in Belgium lately. Mm-hmm. And it's spreading all over the place. We are dealing nowadays, as I used to say lately, in many TV interviews, that we are not dealing with the same organizations as before. Mm. They have gained the clout, they have become more powerful. We are talking about militias, we are talking about armies. Now there is that shift from Iraq and Syria to Libya, and we have more and more concentration of the terrorist activities in and acts in Libya. Libya, it's a neighboring country for us, so this is something that has to do with our national security, and it was important for the two countries to discuss about the latest developments in Libya and to agree to encourage all the parties in Libya to come together and agree on the political settlement of the problems in Libya.
So what's the importance now of the partnership between Egypt and France, as you have kindly mentioned? We have different levels of cooperation on the economic front, on the political front, on fighting terrorism. So what is the importance here of this partnership between Egypt and France in different levels?
We have so many common causes that we share and common interests. We have seen how things have deteriorated in the Middle East lately. Yep. It does affect Egypt, it does affect the whole region and the peoples of the region, but it has affected also France and it has affected the European Union. Yep. President Sisi said the other day at the press conference after the talks between the two presidents and their delegations, he said that we have warned since 2 years of the threat that does constitute the participation of Europeans, including French, in the ranks of Daesh and other terrorist organizations. Yeah. And it will fire back. They will be affected very much. The national security of the European Union countries will be affected. He has warned again and again of such threats. Now we have seen that we were right to alert the European Union and its member countries. Now we have followed also the development of the military cooperation between the two countries. Mm-hmm. Egypt needs to enhance its military capacity, and especially to fight against terrorism in Sinai and in other places in Egypt. And as President Hollande has said the other day, that whatever Egypt will need, to assist in its fight in containing terrorism, we are going to do it. So in fact, the relations are quite wide, they are quite diversified. We need to have more coordination as far as the different regional issues and international issues, be it within an Arab context or an African context. We do value and cherish very much this relationship. When we talk about culture, like for instance, we have seen that the head of the Institute of the Arab World, Institute Jumhur Arab, he is a member of the delegation, and we are discussing about having an exhibition in 2018 on the Suez Canal. We have had exhibitions before at this institute and in other places in France. So it's not the first time, but to focus on the Suez Canal, especially after we have inaugurated the last year the new or the expansion of the Suez Canal in the presence of President Hollande, it is very important, and not just from a cultural point of view, but from an economic point of view. We wouldn't be exhibiting something on the Suez Canal without providing sufficient information about the larger development scheme with regard to the whole Suez Canal region, Port Said, Ismailia, Suez, and the Sinai. So this also will alert many more entrepreneurs in France of the possibilities of investments in Egypt, and it will be a good opportunity to promote investments in Egypt.
Also, President Rondo was keen to visit Egypt's House of Representatives. So what is the significance of this visit?
We have a new parliament.
Yes.
We have a parliament that was elected freely, and we had international observers that have followed on those elections. They have recognized that there was no intervention of the state whatsoever. So we have a more expanded parliament. We have a parliament that has gained a lot of powers according to the new constitution in place. And of course, it's important that we see in the near future interactions between our parliament and the French parliament. We have seen it lately. There was a very negative resolution that was issued by the European Parliament that had addressed or sent a message to the national parliaments, including the French parliament, and through them also the European government, to exercise maximum pressure over Egypt so that it could address the situation as far as human rights status in Egypt. So we need these interactions with the European Parliament, as we have seen that there was an Egyptian delegation that has just finished an important visit, a visit that was very much needed to the European Parliament. They have interacted with the different groups within the Parliament, but also we need to have interactions with the French Parliament. President Hollande is expressing the interest and the importance that France is giving to the relationship with the Egyptian people through their deputies, through the speaker. Of course, we will see visits to come both ways, French Parliament to visit Egypt and vice versa.
Yes.
So it was important to be there and to give the confirmation of the good intentions of France as far as Egypt, the new Egypt, the Egypt mm. of the after June 30, 2013, the fact that they do wish to see those relations between yes. the two countries develop further in the future in every aspect mm. Possible, military, economic, technical, whatever. Mm. So it was important. It fits within the protocol that mm. have to do with the formal visits, mm. the official visits.
Indeed, sir. So do you believe that the level of investment or the percentage of investors, French investors, would increase and the presence of the French companies in Egypt would increase in the coming phase after all these agreements and all these memorandum of understandings that were signed between those countries?
We hope.
Yes, we want to see tangible things on the ground.
We cross our fingers. But we have to understand, and the Egyptians, they have to understand that
yes.
when we sign agreements, it doesn't mean that we are going to
feel it the second day, of course.
Exactly. It's going to take a certain time, especially when you are dealing with mm. Letters of intentions mm. Or memorandum of understanding or memos. We didn't get yet to the phase where we are going to be signing binding agreements mm. That deal with the legal, the financial, the technical aspects of any future cooperation between the two countries. So this matter needs a very close follow-up, which is the responsibility mm. of everybody. Whoever has an interest in Egypt in seeing the future relationship with France developing further, he has to play his role. It's not just the responsibility mm. of the government
Indeed.
Or the president or the ministries, but as we have noticed, those documents that have been signed, they cover a wide range of issues, wide range of fields. So each institution in its yes. field, it has to ensure the follow-up.
Mm.
Now, we are not only talking about the visit of the French president. We are having another important delegation,
yes.
which is the
German
delegation.
German Vice Chancellor, Economy and Energy exactly. Minister, Sigmar Gabriel.
Exactly, yes. and about 160 German entrepreneurs.
Yes.
So, and when we are talking about Germany and France, we are talking about two of the most important countries in the whole of Europe.
Yes.
And two countries that are members of the G7, the most industrialized nations in the world. So they have all the means that we need here, and especially yes. scientific, technical, they have accumulated a lot of expertise and experiences. So we need their assistance, we need their help in achieving our economic and social development schemes for the period 2015-2030. Now, it's good that we see that the two heads of states in Germany and in France have reacted positively to the visits of President Fattahsis to those two countries and are reacting positively as far as our demands for cooperation mm-hmm. in the different fields with those two countries. So we are very much optimistic that such visits are going to add a lot to our relations with the two countries and are going to help Egypt in achieving in better climate, better circumstances, its objectives, economic and social objectives mm-hmm. for the years to come. But let me say the following. We have seen that President Fattahsis has been very active mm. in visiting so many foreign countries.
Yes.
China, Russia, Japan, South Korea, Singapore, Spain,
yes.
Italy, the UK and others. And we have signed so many agreements. Mm. So we have to give our full attention to every and each agreement that we have signed. No matter how or what burden it might constitute to the different departments. Mm. But we have an interest in ensuring that whatever we agree upon will yeah. see the day. It goes with our interest mm. and we have to take such agreements and such deals very seriously. We have to ensure the follow-up. We have signed so many agreements with different countries and if we are going to give such deals the importance they need, we are going really to see the relations between Egypt and those countries developing further in the coming future.
Also, Monday, the French president toured some historical places like Salah al-Din Citadel and the Coptic Museum. So, in your opinion, what is the message he wanted to send to the whole world?
Message to send to the French tourists.
Yes.
I mean, if the French president is here, the vice chancellor of Germany is here, we had King Salman
yes.
of Saudi Arabia, the president of Togo, the president yes. of Mauritania,
Burundian foreign minister.
The foreign minister of the state secretary of the United States.
Yes. Tomorrow is going to visit Egypt, Mr. Jonker.
So that means that Egypt has recovered a lot of its security mm. and stability. So it's more than obvious that the European tourists, they have to come back.
Come back, of course.
Actually, so Germany is studying lifting its travel ban on Egypt. Sorry.
We really hope so.
Yes.
And the sooner the better, because tourism for Egypt is so important, not just because it's one of the main resources of our revenues, but we have millions of Egyptians that work in the field of tourism,
indeed.
Directly or indirectly. Yes. You're talking about 20 million. So you can imagine how much such families, such houses have been affected
yes.
out of the problems that we had with the incident of the Russian aircraft and other instances. Now, I'm just... I want to add something before we end our interview. We have developed our relations with the Russians, so we had the sad incident of the Russian airplane. Mm. We have developed our relations with Italy, and
yes.
we had the problem of the Italian. Citizen
yes.
that was killed here in Egypt a couple of months or 3 months ago. We had the visit of King Salman, which was an unprecedented visit.
Yes.
And we had that whole...
talk about the two islands.
I mean, argument about the Tirana and Sanafir islands. So I just hope after the visit of President Hollande and the visit of the
yes.
Vice Chancellor, we're not going to have similar incidents as far as our relations with the two countries that will affect those relations. I mean,
yes.
the President Assisi said it, and he keeps on repeating that we have from within Egypt and from outside, whoever doesn't want to see Egypt developing or to enjoy a normal relationship mm. with the rest of the world. So I myself, I believe very much in whatever he says.
Yes. So on the regional front, both leaders, of course, did discuss the regional problems and the latest developments concerning these issues in Libya and Syria. So how do you see the Egyptian and French positions regarding the developments taking place in Libya and Syria?
As I said, the two countries are members of the Security Council. They are dealing with such issues constantly.
Mm.
regularly. And the talks between the two presidents, Abdel Fattah Sisi and Hollande, they never stop. They have a very good chemistry, and they have a very good relationship. The two countries, they enjoy strategic relationships. So it's quite obvious that we have to maintain an exchange of views as far as the latest developments pertaining either to the situation in Libya or to the situation in Syria. And we have both expressed on many occasions our interest in seeing that the problems in the two countries are going to be settled peacefully and politically, and we have to encourage the parties, conflicting parties, to halt any hostilities as it happened in Syria, and to give a momentum to any dialogue between those parties, and that time is pressing. We have to attend to those problems. In Syria, we have the problem of the migrants, or the immigrants, about 9 million Syrian
refugees.
Immigrants. It has caused a problem within Europe, and which is more important than the problems that the Europeans have encountered, is the fate of those Syrians. We were talking about a big number of Syrians that have been displaced or have left the country and are living harsh
conditions.
And Libya, the expansion of the presence and the activities of Daesh and other terrorist organizations. So it is important for the two leaders and for the two governments, the two foreign ministries, to maintain such exchanges and to coordinate and to cooperate and to combine efforts in a such way that you could see a good outcome of all those efforts that are being exerted right now, be it from the United Nations or Russia and the United States, or even at the regional level, just to push the parties to settle their problems the quickest possible.
Indeed, Ambassador Ali Al-Hafni, former assistant to the foreign minister, thank you very much for your fresh input and have a lovely day.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you, Mr. Ambassador. And now, dear viewers, I will go for a short break and we'll resume the breakfast show with our second segment for today. So stay tuned.